y'all doing today? Okay, so today I'm coming at you with a video that's just strictly to review the Cabasmezzo. This oldie but a goodie, okay? Now, if you've been on my channel, then you know a long time ago I did a comparison video between the Cabasmezzo and the Cabas Piano, which is the smaller back. I don't have the alto. Obviously, it's the next size up. It's huge, humongous. It's probably going to be similar to a Neverfull GM, so I have that video on my channel, the Neverfull GM, so if you're curious about kind of what an alto might look like, then go to my channel and watch that video. It'll give you an idea. But this one is for the Cabasmezzo, and they don't make this one anymore. In my opinion, this is one of the best tote bags ever. If you like tote bags and you don't have this bag, you need to get this bag. You need to add it to your collection. It's amazing. It's the perfect size. Not too small, not too big. Has a great strap drop and has zipper closure. Not that that's important to me necessarily, but I know it is to a lot of people. And it's just a great bag. I mean, it's a nice looking bag. It's not, you know, not too fancy. It's not super plain. It's like in all different areas, this is such an amazing bag. Okay, so the measurements for this bag, I have it in my notebook. Okay, so the Cabasmezzo is 13 by 12 by 6. Okay, and I just happen to have the alto. It's 19.7 by 14.6 by 6.3. So it's going to be similar in depth only, but the other dimensions are very similar to the Neverfull GM. It's huge. I mean, I've seen it in person. Like I said, I don't have it, but I've seen it in person, and it's huge. It's a nice catch-all tote, not a daily bag tote for sure. Anyway, okay, so, and the strap drop. I did forget to do this, so I'll tell you what the strap drop is. 10 inches, which is perfect. So if you are aware of, like, you know, what you need, what the inches you need to pass the elbow test, it's 10 inches, because this definitely passes the elbow test. Now, it's not as easy as I like. I mean, you can, you know, honestly, it probably depends on your dang arm size, okay, or your elbow, whatever. I have long arms, and so for me, this is perfect. I love being able to have bags, you know. I like being able to do this versus getting a bag and having to do this. Now, not saying that I never do that, but I really think it's super convenient to have a bag, a tote bag, or any bag, really. Well, any shoulder bag that has straps that can pass the elbow test, because you know that it's a pain to be bumping your elbow like this, especially if you're in a hurry, especially if you have little ones and you're trying to gather everyone around, and it's just a pain in the butt. So that's one thing I like. This bag also, okay, I'm going to stand on this chair so you can see I'm showing you. Okay. All right. So here we go. Cabasmezzo. Now, what I was about to say is I like this bag because you can totally access it from your shoulder. Okay. We'll take all this stuff out of there. And I like to keep little fragrance pouches in my bags, because sometimes, you know, the older bags, they might have a storage smell. That helps with that. And then just, I like them to have a fresh smell. So, okay. So, inside is amazing, like I told you. And it has, you know, good organization. It has a D-ring. You guys know that I love me some D-ring. D-ring over there. It has a pretty generous zipper pocket on one wall. Okay, so just to give you an idea, I have an iPhone 6 Plus that will fit side to side in the pocket, and then some. That's not all it'll fit. So here's an iPhone 5 and a chunky OtterBox case that'll fit next to that. And there's still room for more. So, okay, what do I have over here? If I had my mini pochette, that would actually fit in here. But here's the mid-size. This is not the accessory pochette, and it's not the mini. This was one, a size that was included with another bag, and so I call it the mid-size. And so it will fit in there too. Now, with those other two, oh, actually, yeah. Okay, so look. So see, it fits all three things. So the point of me showing you that is just to give you a good reference on how big this pocket is. So it's a nice size pocket. So if you want to keep stuff, you know, even more secure inside, you can. Now on the other side, it has an old size cell phone pocket, which to me is good for packs of gum, lipsticks, lip gloss, what else? You know, whatever, something that's just small over there, maybe some sort of remote, I don't know, like a, I don't know, garage door remote maybe, who knows. Anyway, you can figure out something for it. There's always a use. Okay, but the inside, is, other than that, You could use a bag organizer for this bag. I should have got mine out just to show you what it would look like. I think it makes the bag heavy. So, plus I carry bags in my bags. So, you know, I kind of, the only bag that I really ever carried a bag organizer with was my Speedy 40. I did like my organizer in that just mainly because it made the bottom not droopy. That's really why I liked it. But as far as what will fit in this thing, well, quite a bit. So I'm going to do this from my chair. Okay, so just to show you, again, size reference, this is a Truce 28. And so this fits in here. It's going to take up the majority of the room. So let's say that you didn't want to use a bag organizer, or maybe you didn't want to buy one, but you have this Truce 28. This would make a great bag organizer. In fact, I used to use it before I got my bag organizer. This was my bag organizer because it has these little elastic things on this side. It has a little slip pocket on this side. And so it's just great. The only thing about it is you have to be careful with this too, because of the interior material and the canvas on the outside, it can get kind of heavy. So it will make your bag heavy if you use it. But definitely there's room for it. You can fit, there's still like enough room on one end over here that I could put like a ball of water. And, you know, and you can, well, you know what, actually, okay, so look. Here is my full-size wallet. It's a Kate Spade, but it's the measurements are just like the Louis Vuitton Zippy wallet. It'll fit on the side of the Truce 28, see, without being squished. And then also my accessory pochette, that will also fit next to the wallet. So look, I've got three things side by side in the back. I have the Truce 28, and just so you know, the Truce 28 is 3 inches deep. Is it 3 inches deep? One of them is two and one of them is three. And here, you know what? I have this. Yeah, it's three. I can tell by looking at it. It's three. Yep, it is. Okay, so if that gives you an idea, this thing is 3 inches deep. So you can fit this in here plus the wallet, full-size wallet, plus the accessory pochette. Now, this is only 1.75 inches deep, so it's not that deep. But still, you can fit all these things side by side and you still have plenty of room, because you're going to have everything else that you need inside of your Truce 28. But let's just take that out, okay? And let's just put like regular, well, here's the Truce 23, which again, it would serve the same purpose. It could be like a mini bag organizer. So if you use that in here, okay, well, you still have plenty of room to stack, or not stack, but to put one more thing on the side. So here is my mid-size pochette, and I can put that also. So now everything is side by side. And then I still have room on this end over here, so I could put a water bottle. I could stand it up. It's not going to stick out. And there you go. See? And then I don't use the Truce bags for my bag organizers anymore because they do make them a little heavy. So here's just those three things. These are things that I always carry. And then I also have this little, this is the Coach Cosmetic 17, I think it is. And so it's small. It's a little petite bag. But that fits in here with no problem, okay? And then I didn't even bring any of my big stuff to show you, like the big stuff that fits in here. So I'm looking around to see. Okay, here, wait. Hold on, let's see. Okay. I have this big pouch here. It's an MCM pouch, and it's like 9 by 10, I think. And it fits in here. So this is like the size of, you know, like a calendar or something like that. And so this fits in here, and this definitely is a catch-all tote. Like I said, I wanted to show you my water bottles, how they would fit in here. But basically, like my calendar that I use is roughly this size. So it fits in here. This tote is also a good work tote. So if you have regular full-size folders, those fit, just regular manila folders, not the legal size, just the regular size file folders. Those fit in here without being squished. You can fit, I know I did a video a long time ago on the Compass Mezzo, and I put my 15-inch laptop in here. It wouldn't fit really snug this way. It would fit up and down. It was kind of snug, so I don't really care for that. But this will fit the little small 1-inch binders. Obviously, it'll fit 2-inch binders, even 3-inch file folders. So this could be definitely a work tote also, okay? Because then you have your little side pocket, and you could put your, you know, if you just wanted to have like, you know, your little pochette or whatever, you can fit that in there too. And then you could use this as a mom bag. Okay, so let's say that you want to carry your Truce bag and you want to have your diapers and wipes in your Truce bag, and you can throw this in here. And then you just have your wallet and maybe one other bag, like your pochette that has like your mom essentials, not baby essentials. That totally fits in here too. And so overall, this bag is a great size. I mean, I would say that it's comparable to the Neverfull. You know, the difference is the straps, obviously. These straps, in my opinion, are much more comfortable. They're longer, so you have a longer strap drop on this bag, plus the straps themselves are just wider and thicker. So I feel like it's a more comfortable fit on your shoulder. It's my opinion. I know everybody has different opinions on that, but in my opinion, that they fit better. And then this bag, the Neverfull does not pass the elbow test. If you have that bag, then you know that that's true. If you don't have that bag, then you need to go to my channel and watch my video on that, and you'll see that it does not. I want to say it's a 7-inch drop on the Neverfull, and so it's not going to pass the elbow test. It's a tote bag that you have to place on your shoulder, unlike this one, which, you know, like I said, you can totally just grab and go. Another thing about this one, the Neverfull, and I actually have the measurements. I actually started this little notebook, and it's an address book. And so I just go in the letters and I put the bag, and then that way I can refer to it. Okay, yeah. See, so the Neverfull is 13, which is the same as this one, 11 inches tall, so it's a little bit shorter, and it's 7 inches deep. So the Neverfull is going to be not a lot deeper. Okay, I was going to say a lot, really an inch. So again, you can see that they're very comparable in size. This one, again, in my opinion, is a much better bang for your buck. They're also a lot more affordable than the Neverfull. There's just certain things you have to watch for, though, on these bags. Like, okay, so right here, you want to make sure that the stitching is still intact on all the corners. I do not sell bags where they, or it's not, because I don't like that for me. And so I don't get bags like that. I like for them to all be intact. And then, of course, the bottom is just the Vachetta, but these bags are older. And so you can, you know, if you've seen my channel, then you know that I have like a 7-video series on how I clean them. I don't necessarily protect the leather. I don't use a protectant per se, but the products that I use are, I guess, you know, good at protecting. So anyway, again, Neverfull. This is not the Neverfull. The Cabas Mezzo, one of the best tote bags of all time by Louis Vuitton, except for the Raspel. I do like the Raspel, although it doesn't pass the elbow test. But anyway, this is a great tote. Has multiple uses, and I love it so much. It's super popular. For my little world of, you know, clients, great bag. So I hope this was helpful, and I hope you enjoyed it, and I'll talk to you real soon. Okay, bye!